Today we are going to start a new rhyme, unit 1, the poem The Squirrel. The poem name is The Squirrel and the poet name is Mildred Bowers Armstrong. The poet name is Mildred Bowers Armstrong. Very beautifully the poet described the squirrel about its tail and about its color and what the squirrel likes to do. He very beautifully described it in this poem. I hope everyone has seen the squirrel in the garden or at your surrounding, at your home, or sometimes it is on the tree or sometimes it is playing on the ground. So let's see what poet is saying in this rhyme about the squirrel. He wore a question mark for a tail and overcoated of gray. Here the poet is saying the squirrel, he wore a question mark of tail. That here the poet is saying that he wore, that means the squirrel's tail is looking like a question mark. You can see in your textbook the picture of the squirrel and its tail is just looking like a question mark. That's why the poet is saying he wore a question mark as a tail and overcoated of gray, and the color of this tail is gray. He sat up straight to eat a nut. He liked to tease and play. Now what next poet is saying? The squirrel liked to sit straight. In this picture also the squirrel very nicely straight sitting and eating nuts. He sitting nicely straight and eating the nuts. That means the squirrel likes to eat nuts and he just wants to play on the tree or sometimes on the ground. He likes to tease and play. Now here the poet is saying the squirrel likes to tease. Sometimes if the children is there for playing in the ground, just the squirrel goes just to the children and come back again from the children. That means she just likes to play with others and he just likes to tease again. If we went around his tree, he went the another way. If the squirrel is seated on the one tree and if we go to that tree around the squirrel, he just ran away from there and he just changed his direction and he just went to the another way to play, because squirrel every day, the squirrel wants to play and tease and he likes to eat nuts. Now in the short, I just explained you, here the poet Mildred Bowers Armstrong is saying that the squirrel is like, he beautifully described the animal squirrel, the small animal, the squirrel. He is saying that the squirrel wore the question mark of the tail. That means the squirrel tail is looking like a question mark and it is in the gray color. And he just sat straight and eat the nuts. He likes to sit straight and eat the nuts. That means he likes to eat the nuts. He likes to tease and play. Even the squirrel likes to tease and play. He always plays on the ground, plays on the tree to go from one tree to another tree. And if we ran around this tree, he went the another way. And here at last in the two lines the poet is saying, and he likes to play on the tree, coming down, coming up like this. And here also in the picture you can see on the tree only the squirrel is sitting and eating the nuts. So he is saying he likes to run on the tree, and if we go to the tree around the squirrel, so he just changes his direction and goes to the another way to play and for searching the food. So this is very short poem and very beautifully the poet Mildred Bowers Armstrong describing the about the squirrel. So your homework is this, you have to complete the question answer of this poem in your notebook, and we just turn the page and we are going to start a new unit, A Gift of Chappals, unit number 2. So I just rub this and we are going to start a new unit, A Gift of Chappals. There is one story of Mridu यूनिट टू अ किक ऑफ चप्पल. Unit 2, the gift of chappal. There are two parts in this story, part 1 and part 2. First, we'll see the part 1. What is there in the part 1 and what kind of story it is? I hope first the previous poem, the sphere, you understood and you just have to complete the question answer about that poem, because this poem is very short and sweet. So easily we can understand it. Now next, let's move forward and let's start the unit 2, a gift of chappal. You also open this lesson in your textbook and just look in the book and listen carefully. Mridu is a young girl growing up in Madras. There is one girl, Mridu, and she is growing up girl. She is living with Tapi, her grandmother, and Tata, her grandfather. Then Mridu is living in Chennai with her grandparents Tapi and Tata. One afternoon, Tapi takes her to her aunt Rupumani's house to meet her cousin Lalli, Ravi and Meena. One day, Mridu's grandmother decided to take Mridu at her aunt's house, and what's her aunt's name is Rukumani. What's her aunt's name? Rukumani's house, to meet her cousins Lalli, Ravi and Meena. That means Mridu is having three cousins, Lalli, Ravi and Meena. Now what happened to their house? This lesson is about that. Grandmother took her to the aunt's house, Rukumani's house, and there were three cousins of Mridu, Lalli, Ravi and Meena. Let's see the story. A gift of chappal. A smiling Rukumani threw open the door. Ravi and Meena rushed out and Ravi pulled Mridu into the house. Now see, as soon as the Mridu and her grandmother went to the Rukumani house, very smiling, with smiling face, she opened the door and Meena and Ravi rushed out, and they were very excited to take Mridu, to take her cousin, to take their cousin in the house. So they just pulled Mridu in the house. Then what Mridu said? Wait, let me remove my slipper first. They were in very hurry, that means they were going to show her many things, or they were going to share many of their thoughts or things with Mridu. So they were very excited, so they just pulled Mridu in the house. So Mridu said, wait, let me my slipper first. She get them out neatly near a pair of large black ones. Those were grey actually. You could see the clear mark of every toe on the front part of each slipper. Where she removed her slipper? She removed her slipper beside one black large slipper. There were one pair of slipper which was in black color, but actually it was grey, and the mark of the toes of the slipper was there. In each slipper, the toes mark were there, and beside that slipper only, Mridu removed her slipper also. Mridu didn't have much time to wonder about whose slipper they were, because Ravi dragged her to the backyard behind a thick bitter berry bush. Mridu haven't noticed that whose slipper was there, that means the mark, the toes mark were there on the slipper. So Mridu didn't notice it. She didn't got a minute time to search it. That means whose slipper it was there, the large thin mark of toes in each slipper. Because Ravi dragged her to the backyard. Because Ravi was in very hurry to show her something. So he just pulling her, he just dragged her to the backyard behind a thick bitter berry bush. See, this is the thick bitter berry bush. Bushes means the small plants. It's called a bush. This is the berry bush where the Ravi drank Mridu. There inside a tall football laid with sacking and filled with sand lay a very small kitten lapping up milk from the coconut half shell. Now see, what was there at the berry bush? There was one big tore football, broken football, and it was filled with sand, and one kitty was sitting on that sand, on that football, and the kitty was lapping a milk from the half coconut shell. There was one half broken coconut shell and the kitty is lapping milk. That means Ravi wanted to show Mridu that small kitty who they took her in the house. Now next, we found him outside the gate in the morning. He was meaning, meaning. Poor thing, said Meena. Now Meena is saying, in the morning only we have seen this kitty at our gate. At our gate in the morning we have seen this kitty, and the kitty was saying, meow, meow, meow. It is secret. Amma says, Pati will leave our house and go to the Pattu's mama house if she knows we have a cat. Now what they are saying? Meena is saying, it is very secret. Ravi and Meena saying to Mridu, it is our secret. Mama is saying that if Pati's know if we are having cat at home, so she will leave our house and she will go to the Patumana house. So this is our secret. We didn't tell to our grandmothers and we didn't tell to our mother that we took the kitty in our house. That's why they put the kitty inside the bush. People are always telling us to be kind with animals, but when we are, they scream, oh, don't bring that dirty creature here, said Ravi. Now what Ravi is saying, people always tell to the children, people always tell to us that we should be humble with animals, we should not hurt the animal, we should take care of the animal, we should be kind with animal. But when we do, they only scream on us, they only hate on us. And what they say, don't bring that dirty creature here. That means the people consider the creature, the small animals are dirty, and they do not allow them to take into the house. So what they are saying, the people always tell us to be humble with the animal, but when we do, they do not allow us to bring the such creature, such animal in the house, because according to them, this creature, these animals are dirty. And who is saying this? Ravi is saying to Mridu, do you know how hard it is just to get a little milk from the kitchen? Pati saw me with the glass in my hand just now. Now what next? Ravi is saying, it is very difficult to bring a milk of glass from the kitchen. That means no one is knowing that they are having kitty, and it became very difficult to get a milk from the kitchen. And that Ravi is saying, Pati saw me with a glass in my hand just now. Even his grandmother also saw him that Ravi is having a glass of milk. So just Pati looking at the Ravi. I told her, I'm hungry, I want to drink it. But the way she looked at me, I had to drink most of it to throw her off the scene. Now what? Pati was looking at the Ravi, and Ravi was having a glass of milk. And for what? The Ravi wanted to take the glass of milk for the kitty. But as soon as he just ran away from there, Pati looked at the Ravi and she just observed him. So Ravi just scared, he just hesitated. And he told to grandmother, to his Pati, Pati, I am hungry, so I wanted to drink this milk. Now the Pati looked at the Ravi, and then now the Ravi saying to her, no, I just want to drink it, to mislead the Pati. to mislead the party. He is saying that I just want to drink this milk and I am hungry. I will wash this glass. I will wash this tumbler. So Pati, I will wash it myself. Why should I put you to the trouble? What Ravi is saying, Pati, you don't take a tension. You don't take a trouble. I will not put you in a trouble. I will wash this glass. I will wash the tumbler by myself. I had to run and pour the milk into this coconut shell and then run back and wash the tumbler and put it back before she got really suspicious. Before the Pati got suspicious, what the Ravi did? He ran away and he poured the half milk, because half milk he already drank in front of the Pati. Now the half milk he ran away and he poured and he put half milk in the half coconut shell for the kitty. Now we have to think some another way to feed Mahendran. Now what he is saying, Ravi is saying, now we have to think another way to feed a Mahendran. Now Mahendran is a name of the kitty which they put to call kitty. What's the kitty name is Mahendran. Now what they are saying, Ravi is saying, now we have to find out the another way to feed the kitty, because it's become very difficult to bring a milk from the kitchen because Pati every day watches what we are doing at home. So before they know that we are having cat, so we just have to find out the another way to feed the kitty. Mahendra, this little kitty's name is Mahendra. Mridu was impressed. Now what Mridu is saying, there were three cousins, one Mridu, Meena and Ravi, and they are telling these all things to Mridu because Mridu came to meet them. Now Mahendra, this kitty's name is Mahendra. Mridu was impressed. Mridu got impressed after listening the name of this kitty. It was a real name, not just a cute kitty cat name. Now what Mridu is saying, this is the real name. We can put this name to the any girl, any boy. This is the real name. This is not for an animal and this is not for a kitty name. Who is saying this? Mridu is saying, because she got impressed that Mahendran, this kitty name is Mahendran. This is the real name. This is not for the animal name. Actually his full name is Mahendra Verma Pallav Punai, MP Punai for short if you like. He is like, now what Ravi is saying, actually the kitty's full name is Mahendra Verma Pallav Punai. What he is saying, Ravi is saying, because Mridu is impressed after listening the name of this kitty, Mahendra. So he just saying, Ravi now saying her, this is now the full name of the kitty is Mahendra Verma Pallav Punai, in short MP Punai, if you like. He is saying to Mridu, if you like, it is the short name MP Punai. It's a fine breed cat, just look at his fur like a lion. Now he is saying, look at her cat, she is very fat and her fur is like a lion. He is very beautiful, the cat is very beautiful and her fur is like a lion mane. And you know what the emblem of the ancient Pallav king was, don't you? He looked expectantly at Mridu. And now we see who is Pallav. They were the king named Pallav. That's why they put its name, that the kitty is looking like a king, looking like a lion, because her fur is like a lion. That's why they put her name Mahendram. And Mahendram is, in short, they call the kitty MP Punai. And the long name is, full name is Mahendram Verma Pallav Punai. So he just comparing the kitty to the lion and to the Pallav king. Now what happened to the next, we'll see in our next video. I hope guys you all like this chapter. You hope you like this write the spiral and your homework is you have to complete the question answer of this. And I just give the homework on the board for you. Now what is your homework? You have to complete the before this gift of chappals. We have completed this, right? The spiral. Now the question answer is there. Questions only there. Working with the poem. Why does the poet says the spiral wore a question mark for a tail? Draw a spiral or find a picture of a spiral sitting on the ground and how would you describe its tail? Now what you have to do, you have to draw one picture of a spiral in your notebook and color it properly and write a 5 or 3 sentence and according to the which picture you had will be drawn in your notebook and describe the spiral. Now the second one is, do you usually say that an animal wears a tail? Can we say the animals wear a tail? What do we say? Think, does an animal wear a coat? Consult a dictionary if you like and find out how we are used in different way. This is the question number 2. He liked to tease and play. Who is teasing whom and how? Now you have to find out these questions also. So there are 3 questions, 1, 2, 3 questions, and you have to find out the answer. And in the first one, you have to draw a squirrel picture in your notebook and describe the squirrel in your own word. So this is your squirrel's homework, and after that we have 2 paragraphs. We have completed a gift of chappals. So you have to read the completed paragraph at home. You have to read this 2, 1, 2 and this 3 paragraph at home also, and write down the difficult words of this lesson. I just write here the difficult word for you, and you just have to copy that new words in your notebook. Now you just write down these four new words in your notebook and the question answer you have to complete. This new word is from A Gift of Chappal and homework is from the poem Squirrel. Right? And the new homework is you have to read the three paragraph which we have done right now. We have. I just explained these three paragraph right now. You have to read this all three paragraphs at your home. So the next story we will see in our next video. Till then, hope guys you have understood this story. The next story we will see in our next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care, and please write down this.